Dr. Hathaway, I saw your show the other night on radioactive isotopes, and I've got a question for you.
Yeah?
Is that your real hair?
Yeah.
But tell me, is Mitch by any chance adopted?
Why, no.
It's amazing.
Isn't it?
Look, if I don't get something to eat, I'm going to die. Come on.
Bye, Dr. Hathaway.
Give it.
I'll see you later, honey.
They're really all right. It's just sometimes they have no idea what I'm talking about.
I'm sure about that. So tell me, Mitch, are you going to miss your friends?
Well, no. I think I intimidated the kids.
Good boy. Mitch, there's something you're going to have to understand. Compared to you, most people have the IQ of a carrot. We're different than most people, Mitch. Better.
Oh, there you are, Dr.
Hi. Yes, one second. I've decided to put you on my own research team with some of the finest minds on the campus. This is only the second time I've ever given such an honor to a freshman.
The first one was Chris Knight in 1981, right?
You heard of Chris.
Well, yes, he's a legend in the National Physics Club.
Well, you're going to be working with Chris. He's a senior now, and he's as brilliant as he ever was.
Wow.
As soon as you graduate, this job will be waiting for you, Chris.
Great.
We have a complete physical plant right over here.
You have a jacuzzi?
Absolutely.
Good.
And the labs and offices are right over this way. Follow me, please. Guys, I want you to meet Chris Knight. Chris, this is my assistant, Sherry Nugel.
Nice to meet you.
And this is Mike Dodd.
Dr. Dodd.
The one who just designed our brand new telecom satellite.
It's an honor to meet you, sir. Telecom. Isn't that the satellite that's raining debris all over Europe?
Why is that toy on your head?
Because if I wear it anywhere else, it chafes. I'm sorry. It's just that I didn't want you guys to think I was stuffy, you know. No fun. All brain, no penis.
Pardon me?
I'm sorry. It's just an infantile response to authority.
Yes, you are Chris Knight, aren't you?
I hope so. I'm wearing his underwear.
It's a joke! I get it! That's funny!
Well, I just can't help but you guys are such fun yourselves.
Well, we try to be. Isn't that right, Mike?
No.
Chris, Sherry's going to show you around the place. You can ask her any questions you might have about fringe benefits, dress codes, or whatever, and I'll see you back upstairs in my office when you're through, okay?
Great.
Sherry? Take very good care of this young man. He's one of the 10 finest minds in the country.
Someday I hope to be 2 of them. You are very beautiful.
Thank you.
How'd I come off? Too stuffy?
Well, you certainly don't act like one of the top 10 minds of America.
Really? How many of them have you met?
7.
Really?
Mm-hmm. You'll be 8. Professor Hostetler at MIT was number 6.
Old Professor Hostetler? Isn't he dead?
He is now.